Well, here we are. Hey guys, I hope everyone had a fantastic week. As always, welcome back to Tahir T's channel. Tahir's here. Thank you very much for stopping by. Yet another week went by. Yeah, and now we're finally back in this studio. We're back in New York and, well, it's a little bit of an end of an era, so to speak, because in today's video, I really wanted to just focus and do a little bit of a post-mortem, so to speak, to some of the equipment, my camera, and some of the lenses that I've used in the past year. So if you're really not into the tech conversations, go check out the backlog. I'm sure there are some videos that you might have missed, or just come back next week and there's gonna be a lot more content and there's gonna be a lot of more and new and unique content on this channel. But for today, we're gonna talk a little bit of a camera equipment. I really wanted to talk about this equipment because I think I learned a lot in the last year when it comes to the type of things I can do and cannot do with my existing equipment. So I wanted to spend 5 to 10 minutes talking this week about why I picked this original equipment, how it worked, how it didn't, and what made me pick my next set of the equipment that I'm actually using right now. So that's probably a good segue to say, full disclaimer, this is the very first time I'm using this camera with this lens, with this equipment. So if something will look a little bit off, sorry. I promise I'm gonna learn how to leverage this set of equipment the most, but I'm super excited to have something new to use. And I'm super excited to share a little bit of the experience with these guys because I hope that if you're watching this video and you're currently researching the equipment for your own channel, for your own commercial or business or personal purposes, this video will be helpful. Without further ado, let's talk some cameras. Okay, the camera. It's Nikon D5600. There were a few reasons I picked this camera. First and foremost, it definitely was very budget-friendly camera. I'm pretty sure I did not spend more than $500 to $600 on this camera with this lens kit, with this lens that was already sold together in the package with this camera. The other reason was one of my former co-workers from the current company that I'm employed at, Swapneel, and I'm gonna link his Instagram below. I really liked what he did when he was using this camera for his own photography. So for me, that was a very strong encouragement. That was a very strong endorsement. And finally, I did like the fact that this model of the camera actually has a flip out screen. So it actually helps me when I'm shooting and I can see myself or I can see my surrounding. At the same time, when I'm switching to a different mode, I can just close it off and start looking at the screen this way. This is a little bit of a change because my current camera that I'm looking at, I have no clue what's going on because it actually does not have that flip out screen. So I have to trust its autofocus, which is one of the strongest tools. But anyway, this camera, we're gonna talk about it a little bit later. Among the cons of this particular model, I think the primary one is when you think about the balance between the photos and the videos, Nikons are much stronger in the photography rather than in the video. I think Canon and Sony, they do have an upper leg when it comes to the video production. But for the photo sake, this camera was amazing. For the video sake, I think the biggest cons, right? The biggest con, the biggest negative that I would name about this camera is really the autofocus or lack of it. If you've been long enough with this channel and you've seen some of my early videos or even last week's video, you would see that there were cases when I would lose the focus because I would trust this camera to find the focus spot and it would not. So that's a big one, I think, especially for those people who like to run and gun and just, you know, be able to switch from the close up, switch on their own, maybe switch a little bit further out. That can be tough. Please take into consideration, but at the same time, you can look at probably 95% of the other videos that I've made. And I did not have a problem with the focus because I did not actually trust the autofocus. I would go into the single servo focus, which is essentially, I would open it, point it at myself, and I just tap at my face before I start shooting, or while I'm recording, I would tap it from time to time just to make sure that my face or whatever I'm trying to record at that point is in focus. So please do keep that in mind. Apart from that, that was an amazing camera to have. I really loved using it. I will cherish my memory, so to speak. One final benefit of this camera, sorry for rattling off, but this camera is super light. It's really easy to use, it's really easy to pack. So when you're buying it, that's another benefit to keep in mind. Great cost, great quality. You have my endorsement, I had my friend's endorsement, and definitely the lightweight. Now lenses time. I was gonna about to just throw it up in the air and catch it, but then I realized I'm actually trying to sell these guys, so I should probably handle them with just a little bit more care. Anyway, this is Nikon, and brace with me, they love long names. DXVR AFP Nikkor 10x20mm, that's the focal length, 4.5 to 5.6G, that was the aperture. This lens was my favorite lens since I bought it. I didn't have it at the very beginning, so I was actually using the original lens kit, which we're going to talk about at the end of this video. But since I invested into this lens, it became my primary, kind of like a working horse for a couple of reasons. First and foremost, as you might have seen in the prior video from Jamaica, I love the fact that you can open it wide and you can extend, you know, or I guess decrease your focal length all the way down to 10, which allows you to bring in a lot of the surrounding into your frame. And the only con that I would have mentioned about this particular lens is that it would be a little bit softer around the edges, which for me is a con because I actually prefer my videos super sharp. Just keep that in mind. I do not think it's necessarily a con for everyone, because I've heard that a lot of people do prefer to have it a little bit softer around the edges because it brings in the focus in the middle, yet it still opens it up wide enough for people to see the surrounding. Overall, great lens. I would highly recommend it for anyone who is doing YouTube or the kind of videos where you want to bring in a lot of things into the frame. You want to have a couple of people in front of that camera sitting and talking to each other, or just in general, you want to use it maybe for some real estate purposes. Definitely, highly recommend. Amazing lens. And by the way, don't worry if you won't catch every single name of all the lenses. They're gonna be in the description below, so feel free to check them out. Now, the second lens I wanna talk about is IFS 50mm lens, which is, I think, 1.8, right? Yep, 1.8 aperture. This lens is amazing for the portrait photography. So again, Sunil was the person who actually recommended me this lens for the portrait photography, and I loved it for that initial use case. But once I started doing more of the video, this lens was super useful as well, because it does blur out and creates this nice bokeh, what they call effect, all the way outside of your focal point. So if you have a person in the middle in focus, there'll be a nice and blurry and buttery background around them. That's super cool. That brings the attention to whatever you have in focus. And in general, I love this lens because of its price. This is a very budget-friendly lens. I think it's about $150 new, so you can probably scoop it up on eBay in less than $100 in a very decent quality. And if I would recommend you one lens to invest in besides your lens kit that you would probably get with the same Nikon camera, that would be this lens. Because I did fine with the lens kit. 10 to 20 millimeter lens is about twice as expensive as this one, but the type of use you can get out of this lens is pretty fascinating, as I've mentioned, between the portrait photography and even some of the B-roll that I did. A good example would be the Twofoldtown distillery video, where I used it to record everything inside the store, and especially because of the wide aperture of 1.8, you get a lot of light into this lens, so it helps you in the low light environment. Again, highly recommend. And in terms of the cons, the only con I would mention is the sound of the autofocus. Do not keep it on the autofocus when you're shooting the video, unless you're not going to use the soundtrack from that video recording, because as this thing keeps adjusting the focus, it makes this mechanical noise that you will definitely will not be able to remove from your audio if, again, you're using that audio track. So just keep that in mind about this lens. But overall, again, I would highly recommend investing into this lens. The next contender for your money when it comes to buying Nikon lenses is this bad boy, AFS Nikkor 70x300mm, and it also has with the aperture 4.5 to 5.6. As I've mentioned in my prior video, this is a beast. You know, between the size when you fully extend it to the 300mm focal length, and just in general the weight, this is a pretty solid lens. I really liked it for the photography. I would highly recommend this lens for the photography, especially if you're taking pictures of some sporting event or the animals. I used it in the animal parks, and I used it during my attendance to the Formula One weekend in Austin, Texas last October. Super useful for those kind of things. So if you're looking for the nice telephoto lens and you're using a Nikon camera, I would recommend this, especially again, because currently you can buy them on eBay for, I think, under $300, which is, I think, is a great price for this kind of lens. The only con that I would mention is that if you plan to use it for the videography, if you're planning to use it to shoot videos for YouTube, skip this lens. Invest in something else, because I barely used it. I used it only on a couple of occasions for the video, and even then I found it to be much harder to use in the video scenario. rather than for the photography. Between stabilization that you have to keep, especially as you fully extend it because of the fact that you're all the way out there with your focal length, and the fact that you cannot really go and run and gun with it because, again, it's super heavy compared to the other lenses. Not worth your investment for the video, honestly. But for the photography, if you want to keep it a nice balanced bag between a couple of the other lenses that I've mentioned for the video and this one for the photo, that might actually work and round up your suite of different tools nicely. And finally, honorable mention, 18x35 Nikon lens, which is essentially called lens kit. This is like the basic type of lens you can get. And in most cases, you will get it together with your camera when it comes to those, you know, entry-level D5600 kind of Nikons. Honestly, I really enjoyed this lens. I had this lens as my primary workhorse before I bought 10x20mm, which was like a couple of months into this channel. So there are at least 10 to 20 videos shot exclusively on this lens. Cannot say anything bad about it. Cheap, great quality, sharp, easy to use. If you really have to be nitpicky, this whole release and lock function, you cannot open it. You actually have to press to release it, and then it locked. And then if you want to close it, you have to press it again. I have no clue why they did that. It does not make sense, but you do get used to it. Overall, honorable mention does go to this lens because I loved using it. It was super helpful. And yeah, that was the lens. That was the very first lens that we shot the very first video on. So, you know, thank you, little one. Mwah. And this is it. This is my video about my equipment circa season of 2017 to 2018. I did quite enjoy using this equipment, the camera and all the lenses. And I hope you, as you're researching currently your equipment, and if you found this video because you are researching the Nikon cameras and the Nikon lenses, you found it helpful. I think my closing advice is follow my footsteps. Do not go and spend a ton of money on a very expensive equipment, because you really need to understand what is your use case. How are you gonna be using the cameras as you buy them? And the same applies to the lenses. You don't wanna drop a ton of money and then realize that this is not exactly what you need. And then you have to go through the whole hustle of selling them back on eBay. Buy something inexpensive like this Nikon D5600. Use it for a little while, for the first 3-6 months. Try it out in different kind of environments for different kind of use cases. If it's a photography, if it's a video, try a different kind of photography, try a different kind of video. And only then, as you gain the experience, as you understand what works and what doesn't work for you, start considering and start researching for your next camera, for your next lens. And now that I'm thinking about it, it's kind of weird that I shot the video about the old camera on the new camera. It's almost like when you know, when you have this default internet browser, like Internet Explorer on your laptop, and the first thing you do is you go and you download Chrome, that's the same kind of feeling. Well, anyways, now it's time to pack up that equipment, put it on eBay, and hopefully recoup a little bit of the cost and help my bruised up bank account after investing in this new equipment. Feel free to share your stories about how you approached investing and buying the equipment for your business or your personal use in the comments below. I'm super curious to hear if you followed a similar kind of step, or you actually went and saved up money and invested in the more expensive equipment. And in conclusion, thank you very much for stopping by. If you're new to this channel, go ahead, hit the subscribe button and check out the backlog. And if you're already a subscriber, thank you very much for stopping by and sticking through this video. As always, let me know in the comments below what you thought about this video, and I will see you all next Saturday, 10 a.m. Eastern, on this very channel. Time to go and make some money on eBay. Bye-bye!